Is anybody else sick and tired of these fake journalists on YouTube, especially in the gaming community, where the entire premise of their channel is pretty much to just read articles verbatim, talk for maybe 2 minutes about what their actual opinion is, and most of those opinions are just generic talking points that don't really offer anything of substance, and those opinions only make up a small portion of the video, most of it is them just regurgitating news articles? This is pretty much their daily routine, okay? Every morning, they go on N4G, look for the hottest gaming stories, find an interesting article, and then sit and record themselves all day rereading these articles to you like you're a two-year-old that can't just go read it yourself. I mean, most of these people are too lazy to at least summarize the article. No, they're just reading it verbatim. And some of these people have the balls to call themselves journalists. I'm sorry, but what kind of journalism are you doing? What are you contributing to the story besides reading what other people wrote and essentially profiting off the work of others, because you can't do that work yourself? These creators, if you even want to call them that, they're nothing but parasites. They're not creating anything of value. And when it's a slow news day, oh no, that means the parasite doesn't have a host that they can leech onto and suck the life out of. And in that case, they have two options. The first option is to actually be creative and make something of value, but we know that's not gonna happen. They're either incapable or just too lazy to come up with something on their own. So the second option is to hop off N4G, go on Twitter instead, look at what's trending over there. Oh, look what we have over here. There's a comment from someone on YouTube, some random account that claims to be an insider source. I have all this inside information. Yeah, I'm just some random schmuck on the internet, but that doesn't matter. You can trust me. Yeah, I have all this inside information about the PlayStation 5. Ooh. Yeah, it doesn't matter if this is just some random comment that literally anybody can make on YouTube. I can go tomorrow and say I have inside information and leave an anonymous comment on some sock account. None of that shit matters. All that matters is the almighty dollar with a clickbait title that says, "The PS5 is in serious trouble," all caps. And what happens? People click on it, of course, because you're talking about a new console, something that you don't have a lot of information about, and with a title like that claiming the PS5 is in serious trouble, you know that's gonna rile the fanboys up, and it's gonna start a console flame war. I mean, that's the point of clickbait, is to get people to click on your video. Even if the source in question is less than reliable, it doesn't matter, integrity, all that stuff, who cares, as long as I got money. You need to understand these people thrive on negativity, because negative stories get far more attention than positive ones. That's the nature of journalism in general, but the thing is, these people aren't even journalists, they're frauds. And I think the icing on top is when they ask for money, the e-begging, oh my god. And you know what? I used to be an e-begger. I made a video one time asking people to donate money for a gaming PC. Certainly not one of my best moments, and I'm still ashamed of that to this day, okay? I'm gonna admit that. But at least I was an 18-year-old kid when I did that, and these people are in their mid to late 30s, sometimes in their 40s, asking people to pay their bills for them. Please help me pay my mortgage. Help me pay my taxes. The IRS is coming after me. And the thing that I find the funniest is when these people ask to give them money to get their car fixed. Like, where is your fat ass going? You don't got a job. You just sit on your ass all day making YouTube videos. And when I mean making YouTube videos, I mean stealing content from other people. Enough with the GoFundMe. Go fund yourself. That's what most of us do when we need to pay for something. Why can't you? I also love the Patreon thing where if you pay me $10 a month, I might have a conversation with you. Like, who the fuck are you? But then they give the sob story of, oh, I don't make money off ad revenue anymore. I get the yellow dollar sign in my videos. I'm not ad friendly. YouTube is demonetizing my channel. Fuck you. We all got our own problems we gotta deal with, especially in a hard time like this. We don't need to hear yours. I'm sorry, but you're not that important. You're not a family member. You're not even a friend. You're just some random asshole online, okay? And that's the reason why I'm not very active in the gaming community, especially the YouTube gaming community. There are very few people on this platform that I even respect, because most of these creators are just self-righteous assholes. And I'll be the first to admit that I don't have a perfect history on this platform myself, but I'd like to think I've made significant progress over the years, and that I'm willing to own up to my mistakes and make sure I don't repeat them ever again. If I'm wrong on that, please let me know in the comments. But anyway, this went way out of hand. I don't know what made me decide to make an incoherent rant video today, but whatever. Sometimes you just gotta vent shit out, right? But with that said, don't forget to like this video. It really helps with my low self-esteem. Please subscribe to my channel also because I need that self-validation. But most importantly, do not go to adblock.org and install Adblock onto your web browser. Because really, if I can't make any money off of these videos because you have that pesky Adblocker installed, then I might as well quit. But I won't quit if you go to your iOS or Android device right now and install Raid Shadow Legend. And also check out my OnlyFans.